Hello everyone, this is Marco, and with me I have Oscar, and we have our special guest today, Puchir. And we are here in Lhasa, Tibet. It's a busy street in the back, and we are inside, we're now stepping inside this very beautiful Tibetan gift shop. So, I mean, it was pretty busy just then. You know, there are lots of people walking, so we step inside quick. So let's do the introduction here, man. Sorry about that.
Oh, no problem.
Okay, all right. So, so Oscar?
Yes, we're the Bearded Brothers, and I'm really happy for one that we have a Puchir here who can explain what some of these items are, because I keep seeing them in the street. So first of all, can we start off with these? I see a lot of people holding them with a hand and spinning them around, and I really want to know what this means.
Okay, so, you know, don't be so, you know, get down to the souvenir so quick. I know you're so eagerly to have one.
Oh.
But, you know, Puchir is the special guest we invite today. You know, she's a beautiful Tibetan girl, as you can probably see. So can we just give a second for her to say hello to our followers on CGTN? Oh.
这是的嘞，我是普赤，我长居住在拉萨，然后我这边讲一些藏文化方面的视频，然后讲一些西藏这边的一些景点，还有习俗等，就这些。对。Okay,
so quick translation. You know, Puchir is a famous vlogger here, based in Lhasa, Tibet. She got a lot of followers online. 你有很多的粉丝，对吧？在线上。 She got a lot of followers online. She do like beautiful videos introducing the beautiful culture of Tibet. You should follow her.
I will, because, you know, she's helped us a lot so much lately. And I'm sorry for jumping the gun a little earlier, because I was just so excited. I wanted to know what these things are. There's so many items in this shop that we're curious about.
Okay. So I mean, we are surrounded by all these beautiful, you know, gifts and, you know, handicrafts. But, you know, you can probably see there's one.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me move over here.
All right, so okay.
We can get a good view.
Yeah, right. I mean, so this is first thing came to my eyes. So, Puchir, can you please tell us what it is? 就是你能给我们介绍一下这个大概是什么吗？OK.
这是我们西藏这边叫藏羊头，就是羊头嘛。我们每年就是藏历年的时候，初一的时候都会摆这个。然后我们初一的时候都要吃羊头，就这样。OK.
So, do you know what it is, man?
No, I mean, look, in back in Texas, where I come from,
okay,
this is more of a decoration. It's more of like something that you use at a ranch or something like that.
Yep.
But I just wonder, there's a lot of ornaments around this skull. So is this religious? What's the use for this?
It is kind of related to Tibetan, because Puchir just said they will probably put up a goat's head. A Tibetan goat head, of course, as an ornament as well, but only they put it on the first day of the Tibetan New Year.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
So it's a festivity kind of thing, and they will have a dish of sheep's head on the very, you know, like we have dumplings on the Chinese New Year.
Right.
If they eat the sheep's head for the Tibetan New Year.
Okay.
所以说我们藏历新年的时候，各家都会吃这个羊头，是吧？对对对，都会吃羊头。
然后这个藏语叫龙哥，龙哥，对，OK，龙哥，龙哥
is the Tibetan word. Can you try that?
龙哥.
Oh yeah. yeah. So it's more than a decoration. I mean, after they finish the meat, so they put some, you know, in. Would you call that like a golden kind of embellishments on it?
Exactly. And then you know, you see a lot of scarves here.
Right.
I assume this is also very significant and symbolic of, I guess, the celebrations that you just described.
Yeah. Right. I mean, speaking of decorations, I think the most common, you know, thing probably see here, you know, as Puchir told me earlier, you know, is tanka, right?
Oh.
So, can you show us some examples of tanka? 就是你可以给我们看一下这个礼品店里有卖的一些唐卡什么的吗？
Okay, okay, okay.
你可以看一下。好，just follow me, yeah? Okay, here it is, man.
Oh.
So this is the tanka.
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
No.
Oh, okay. So, you know what she just said? Okay, so you know, for those of you who just tuned in, we are just introducing a very traditional Tibetan art called tanka. Now, you know, Oscar just, you know, used his finger to point it at the tanka. But Puchi just said, you know, it is impolite to do that because, you know.
I'm so sorry.
Second mistake, you know,
not
your first time. Okay.
唐卡的话里面画的都是佛像呀，现在这里面画的是轮回嘛，就是坛城，也叫轮回，就是算是就是佛像嘛，所以就这样指，只要是我们藏族，基本上不会这样指的，都是这样指，对 ，OK.
So you know, let me just roughly translate what Puchi just said. She said in the Tibetan culture, because this is you know, Oscar, if you can have a close look of that. You know, it's in a circle. You know what? You know, yeah, it's okay. You just step. You know,
I'll step in. I'm gonna cross.
Right. Yeah. It's all right. I mean, you can see that it is in a square. You know, that resembles reincarnation because reincarnation is a very very important notion in Buddhism. So that is, you know, tanka is a very famous art. So what you make tanka, you paint it on the cloth. You know, 就是我们是要在布上画这个唐卡的，对吧？对对，就是唐卡布上画的，就是画之前要打磨，然后再画唐卡。然后唐卡的颜料是矿物颜料，矿物颜料，那过了很久时间也不会掉色的，就有这种特色。So
You are about to say? I was just going to say, I was going to ask because this is the first time I see a tanka that is designed in this way. Typically, we see maybe the picture of Buddha or something like that, or some sort of, different designs, different interpretations, but I've never seen one that looks like square like that. So what makes a tanka? You know, what makes it unique, a tanka? Because I never would have thought that would be one.
You know, it is very related to religious kind of, you know, 他想让你介绍一下这个唐卡上面的这些主题，它上面有画一些什么东西啊？哦，上面画的是轮回，就是坛城嘛，上面画的是轮回，然后有些唐卡上面画就是佛像，画的都是佛像，然后也会画唐卡，就是轮回、坛城都会画的。这里面画的是坛城，就是轮回嘛。So
this
is, you know, for tanka, it's a very common, it's a religious symbol. You know, they put it on it. So you put, they use a cloth, they polish the cloth first, and then they dyed it in a special, you know, kind of color, natural color. So it can last for, you know, years and decades. You know, it is very, very, you know, common in Tibetan household. But, you know, do remember, next time you do it that way.
This way. And
yeah.
No pointing.
Right.
No pointing
and Tibetan people like to, you know, greet people this way, right?
就是这个是一个，就是这样是一个尊称嘛，尊敬，对，尊敬。
Yeah, I mean,
okay, very nice.
All right, yeah, I mean, we learn something every day. Yeah,
exactly. That's why we have her, and I'm so grateful that we have her here.
Okay, so let's back to the theme of our, you know, trip this time. So, because here, I mean, this is a kind like an old street, you know, of Lhasa, and we have a lot of famous restaurants as well as tea house here in the nearby. So just not far away from us, there is a very, very famous tea house called Guangming Gangqiong Sweet Tea House. So sorry, 谢谢你纠正我这个. So you know, after we have a tour of this Tibetan, you know, art, so why don't we just sit down and have a cup of tea, because that is considered the most authentic Tibetan way of life.
And I also heard before we started the broadcast that this tea house is probably one of the most popular ones in town, probably one of the oldest ones as well.
Yeah.
So let's find out more, because I'm very curious and I want everybody to see how this place looks like.
And to be honest, we are very, very thirsty at the moment.
Yeah, we are. It's
yeah.
very dry here.
And yeah, so, you know, without further ado, like, you know, lady first.
Yes.
先走吧,我们去茶馆,好。来, okay. So, I mean, it's a beautiful surroundings here. So Puchi, you have a very I want to ask her, because she wear a very, very beautiful traditional Tibetan costumes.
I'm most fan of those shoes. The shoes are really, really pretty.
So Puchi, 其实她就是我们都觉得今天你穿的这身藏服非常的漂亮，所以说这个是你自己的藏服吗？可以跟我们讲一下吗？
Okay, 我这个藏服是我妈妈纯手工编织的。Oh,
okay. Her mother made it for her.
Oh, really? Wow. Well, she's got some skill, because that's really cool. Yeah, that's really nice.
Okay.
Oh, also the shoes as well, the shoes?
就是这个鞋也是妈妈做的吗？
不是，鞋是专门有人会做的，这个要需要专业的手工，所以我们妈妈不会做。但这个是纯羊毛做的，我藏装是纯羊毛的。
So this is made by her mom. You know, it's a beautiful, you know, made of wool, kind of, you know, special. But that is, you know, designed by some special personnel.
Yeah.
You know, can you make a shoe?
No, of course not. I was just wondering.
Yeah, all right. I mean, we don't know nothing about this garments and nothing. But that is a beautiful Tibetan costume because, you know, this is the second day of Shodan Festival. 因为昨天是雪顿节，对不对？
所以说
昨天雪顿节，现在我们其实是不是还是就是在这个节庆氛围里，大家还是会穿一些藏装这种东西。
对对对，只要是有这种节日的话，都会穿藏装。对对。
Okay, so it's a kind of a festival costume. So, all right, so it's not too far away from where we just at. You know, we are here approaching. Can we have a shot of the sign of the tea house? It's called how do we say that in Tibetan though? 就是藏语这个怎么说？
藏语的话，我是根据查看。对，我是根据查看。
We see.
Gumjum.
Chakang.
Chakang. Chakang 就是甜茶，不是茶馆的意思。
茶馆怎么说？茶馆是。
茶馆是Chakang。
Chakang. Okay. Did you follow that?
I tried.
Okay. All right. I think we just had too much talking. So let's step inside, man. Let's go inside. Let's go inside to see how it looks like actually. Okay. Okay. Thank you. 不吃。行，帮我们带一下路吧。谢谢你啊。You know, from here, you know, probably, you know, Putri is trying to look for some space here, but it is a very crowded place. I think it's 4 p.m. In the afternoon. This place is usually more busy in the morning, but now it is, you know, still very busy, you know, nearing closing time. This is probably the oldest tea house now in Lhasa, Tibet. You know, the owner just told me that it has been operating here for hundreds of years, so it passing from different generations. So, you know, here we are. Luckily, we just find a seat here. It's usually very, very crowded. So, without further ado, let's join them, you know. Let's step down, sitting on the table. Putri is very gracefully helping us to make a cup of tea.
Very nice. You know what? I'm going to let her pour that tea, and I'm going to get on this side, because you are a translator here. So here, I'll hold this for you while we move.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we can sit in the same line, and yeah.
So. Okay, can you ask her if she can jump in to this other side, because, or actually, I'll let you come in first so that you'll be in the middle.
No worries.
Let's do that.
Okay.
Much.
Okay.
A bit of a shuffling here.
Yeah. It is usually to very, very crowded place here. And Putri is making us sweet tea. I mean, sweet tea, you know, this place, as you can see, is probably very old one. But sweet tea is relatively new to Tibet. Do you know that? You know?
I didn't know that. I mean, I've heard of the butter tea, right? But I didn't know sweet tea was like a new introduction. I would like to know what Putri here...usually likes to order. What she typically orders when she comes here?
Okay. 就是 so let me slip it into
question.
You submitted too much information going on. And 就是说其实我们知道这个甜茶的话其实不像酥油茶它是藏族最早最最传统的一个东西它是比较新的一个东西是不是
对对对现在条件好了嘛现在有甜茶以前的话只有酥油茶然后甜茶是从印度进过来的所以现在有甜茶以前的话只有酥油茶
所以你小的时候就有甜茶吗
我小的时候没喝过甜茶呵呵条件没有那么好
She said this is something relatively new it's like it, you know it's not because yak butter tea like we had before it is you know traditionalclassic Tibetan kind of tea but this is actually imported from India
oh really oh wow yeah. okay because we're so close of course
wow, oh wow
we just get here
okay oh okay, we're
you said tea house earlier today or tea house but I didn't expect noodles
okay can I ask her yeah 就是为什么我们觉得这是一个茶馆它还会给我们就是它会有藏面呢
藏面的话我们平时都会吃的只要坐下来吃点藏面然后喝甜茶都是这是我们的习惯
就是一天一天什么时候都会吃是吧？
对对对对。
Okay, okay. So, so I mean, this is a very old place, you know, for, you know, just the surroundings. It seems like it has been here for over like 50 years or something. So, and, do you know, so I'm going to ask her if she knows anything about the history.
Yeah, we'd like to know the history because definitely, as I can see, the place looks very old.
Yep.
So I'm assuming it's a very traditional, like the go-to place for sweet tea. But yeah, I'd like to know more about the history. When was this place opened? When did it open?
Yeah. 就是不是你知道这个茶馆的一些历史吗？或者是你知道它的一些就是这么多年的变化吗？
哦，我是不太清楚，因为我是2016年才到拉萨的，那时候上大学嘛，所以不太清楚。我可以叫一下我们的老板呀。
好好好。
OK
OK。So we are very honored to invite the owner of the tea house to join us. You know, 不是 please do us a favor. 哎呀，好，不是你叫他过来吧？啊，好，啊 ，OK。Yeah. Huh? Okay.
There we go.
So there we go.
It's a very packed place, so seating is always tricky right here.
Yeah, everybody is struggling for seats, but we are winner. 首先非常非常非常哦。
Yeah.
Oh. So 非常谢谢您今天过来跟我们聊一聊。好，不是Since the owner of the tea house speaks mainly Tibetan,
okay.
So I'm gonna let Puchu to translate, and then I'm gonna translate in English. So it's gonna be a long process. It's gonna take some
awful hard job.
Yeah, yeah, man, but it's okay. Well, so, Puchu, 所以说我们想就是问这个这位老先生一些问题，好吧？
好，
就你帮我们用藏语翻译一下。
Okay.
对，就是我们主要想问一下，就是这个看起来是一间很老的茶馆了。就是您呢在这里应该就是也有很多年了，您能给我讲一下这间茶馆它的历史吗？
跟了几我这个茶馆给地面都给六九千的这个是啥
我这三个的顿就顿间落了呀，我说做不了，各地的三个群居就做不了吧，地的小不觉得做不了啊，对呢，还得打沙岗个土著间咯，老新鲜，你都做过嘞，顿就顿间老了做不来，来别自己想的，顿间老了做不来，啊嘞，打新鲜你清不了吧？啊对呢，哦，看来是那地巴拉了，啊那片地都没说呢，啊那全部修清的哦了吧？打工作都没说呢，见那打粮食拿了，啊那打几打沙岗吃血菜嘞，我顶着就是土著领袖怎么的呀？我顶这姐姐，俺俺做做个大地那个地里，比如在长安嘛，哦地里，俺学了大地下学渣的摘菜呀，光哦顶这凉面啥的，咱们这说过了吧，我都行。
It's a long history. It's a long answer, man.
我觉得这历史一定很长，因为他说了很多，所以你还能记得吗？
就是大概的话，他说就是七八年这个茶馆刚开始的时候，1978年开的。我就这样一想，我爸爸是1976年生的，你看这个历史有多长。
Okay, let me translate this part first. This one is opened in 1978.
Okay.
1978, and her father was born in 1976.
Okay.
So I mean, it's a really long history.
然后以前茶馆在对面。然后后来搬到这里的，以前的话这个茶馆特别小，后来就是就是生意好嘛，然后就变大了。
So it used to be on the other side of the street. It used to be a very small one. You know, this is like a kind of spacious here.
Yeah, definitely.
But they move it from the other side of the street here. 就是从街的那边搬过来的啊。
对对，搬过来的。然后这里面主要吃的是就是藏面还有甜茶。然后他们顺便做一些那个叫什么炸土豆呀，还有肉饼，还有一些盖饭等，就这有这种。
So they are not only offering sweet tea, which is you know their best and most famous for, and they also offering some very simple food.
Okay.
You know, like noodles. This is called Tibetan noodles. I never tried this before. I mean, honestly, I mean, I've been here before, but never tried the Tibetan noodle before. It has a unique flavor.
还有就是大概就是这个样子。
That's about it, man.
Well, I have one more question for the owner, if that's possible.
Yeah,
because if he moved from across the street over here, That means that it got very popular. So I want to hear from him. What do customers tell him? Why is it so popular? Why does he believe that this is just such a place to come? Like, why would one want to come here? Yeah.
其实这个问题很简单，就说他搬家了一次，是因为这个茶馆它很有知名度，很多客人非常喜欢来这儿。所以说，咱们可以问问咱们的茶馆老板，他有什么很好的经验啊，或者是为什么有这么多的客人都那么喜欢来他的茶馆？
因为这个是他刚才说的，这个是拉萨这边最大的一个茶馆，
哦，
也开的最久嘛。
我们让老板自己翻译一下给他。
OK。你注意。
没有，您翻译给他刚才的这个问题，让他来回答一下就可以了。
OK。原来俺最对吧？他他都读这个是对头，用在开的精力开的钱吧，是他俺最给。
他这个呢，咱们各地都涨吧，大概嘞很多老年休工了，俺那他的珍珠国土不是吧？珍珠是吧？竞争啥个蒙古族啊，各地都啥个些了嘛啦？唐古集团，俺的那俺最的那做这个布置，工作个协助，啊涨着。从左岗从那前，哎，吃的他就俺的鼻子那里呀，啥个下面的解药嘛的，俺就全都搁这带带了，俺都俺没有打个了，俺带着，俺广州带，你不是不能够多啊，俺加上俺的广州蒙古这个这边呀，我的嘞，所以这的鼻子的，我就别讲了，他专门买不着，我的姐姐，俺的广州港的搞不是不能够嘛吧，我的这的。
就是二十多年前没有茶馆嘛，没有那么多茶馆，然后后面有茶馆，然后竞争特别大的竞争嘛，
特别大的什么
竞争？
竞争
啊，对，
竞争，
对，竞争很大嘛，所以他们把服务呀，还有就是甜茶的，也就是甜茶做的时候有每个人做的都不一样嘛，
配方，
对对对，就都上面就是提升了，所以做到现在。
Okay, so he said, you know, when he was first started, you know, because there's like a lot of competition. Sorry for long waiting though, you know, it's a lot of competition going on. So he kind of perfected his way of, you know, his ingredients in that cup of tea. And he kind of maintained it and he, you know, tried to, you know, optimize his service, optimize, you know, so there's a lot of customers, you know, coming from, you know, their grandfather's generation.Father's generation and their children's generation.
Yeah, makes a lot of sense.
This becomes a collective memory of local people.
Yeah. I can imagine so. I mean, I would say that the walls speak and echo a bunch of, you know.
That's history.
It's history, right? And the tables as well, it looks so old. When are we going to have some tea?
I mean, since we have been looking into this delicious food for so long,I mean, 我们可不可以先谢谢老板，因为他肯定很忙，他还要去忙别的东西，所以谢谢您，谢谢您，谢谢您，来，谢谢您接我们采访 ，OK， 谢谢 ，All right, OK, so he's busy and yeah, we just try the cup of tea. 我们来尝一下我们的甜茶吧，好。
Cheers.
Okay.
Cheers. 不能这样。Do we do this? Do we not do that for
a chat? Oh, you don't do that. Okay.
Sorry.
We don't do toasting with the tea. Sorry about that.
That's very refreshing.
然后甜茶的话，就是只要是茶的话，不能干了，就要留那么一点，对，就要那么留。这不是酒，这是茶嘛，所以不能干了。
Another mistake coming.
Oh, no, man,
come on, you know.
What did I do now?
Well, what Puchi just said is this is like cup of tea.
Right?
It's not like shots. You're not supposed to down it, you know.
I am so thirsty.
Yeah, I know. I'm thirsty as well. But you know, you have to leave you know, just some like a, you know.
Okay.
A little bit in the bottom.
Enjoy it, right? Because I typically like
to
go for it.
Yeah, that's a typical Chinese kind of way of enjoying, you know, appreciating the beautiful flavor of the tea. You know, for me, it tastes like a milk tea.
Right.
Yeah, definitely. But it has a, like, a, how do I say this? I think it has a, like, green tea undertone to it. I'm not sure if they're using green tea, but it just feels me like...
Yeah, no, I agree. And it's very much, it reminds me, just like you said, of the sweet milk tea back in Beijing, for example, and
right.
that we have so accustomed to.
But, you know, if we can zoom the camera on the other table, you know, you can see some, okay. We can see something, some people put cash on the table as well. You know, that's the way if you want to refill your tea, you know, put some cash on your table. So that way, you know, people can refill the tea for you. 就说这个在桌上放钱的这个传统是到底是怎么？
这个传统是从甜茶馆刚开始就是七八年刚开始到现在一直没有丢。你看，除了光明甜茶馆之外，其他甜茶馆都没有这个习惯。就这个是一直留下来的。
Oh, that's a unique kind of thing in this very tea house. They don't do it in other places, man.
Oh, the cash thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because there are so many people coming, they need to keep the business running unstoppingly. So, you know. Anyway.
That's a really good sign there.
Anyway, I mean, I cannot. I cannot, you know, I mean, you know, for... Because we've been staring at the noodle for so long,
yeah,
man.
I wonder if they're still warm. Yeah, they're still warm.
Yeah. 所以说这个藏面吃起来有什么讲究？
吃藏面的时候，你们可以全部都可以吃一些。其余的讲究的话，怎么说？我们的话就是有一些特别的日子的话，不会吃肉，就是直接吃素，就只有面，没有这个汤也是肉汤，就是肉汤。
牛肉做的是。
OK， 对，牦牛肉做的。
所以。
Yeah.
对，你们可以。
So you can finish the noodle, no worries, man. Yeah, you have a try. You have a try first. I'll follow you, man. 你要不要吃一把？你要不尝
尝？
没有，我们尝一下就好啊。好的，好的。After you, I'm going to hold the mic.
Let's see if I don't make a mess here.
Yeah.
All right. It's the starch that you need and the carbs that you need in order to survive here in Tibet. I can tell you that it's very carby, but very delicious. Yeah, yeah. So
you're saying the noodle is very chewy?
Yeah, very chewy, very heavy. But it's got also, the broth has a really nice spiciness to it.
Yeah.
That it makes you just want to go for more and more. And I don't know about you, but I'm hungry and I want to keep eating this.
All right, okay. Yeah. So before you finish this bowl of noodle real quick, you know, can we just say a little shout out to our followers and people who are watching this live stream? You know, we're live in Lhasa, a famous sweet tea house in Lhasa. And please leave a comment, you know, share it to your friends who might be interested, because that's a very, very precious chance. For us to be, yeah.
Yeah, speaking of our viewers and trying to make comments, we do have a couple of comments that came into our cell phone here.
Right.
Albert Chu says, oh, very nice weather in Lhasa. You guys must be enjoying it very well, which is very true.
It's true.
And also, Aloka says, tell me if I'm pronouncing this wrong. It's Barkwa Street.
You went there. Yes, yeah,
I know,
yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
The pronunciation, I just need to learn this because I'm so off.
Yeah, yeah.
He said, Aloka says it's absolutely mesmerizing.
Mesmerizing.
I completely agree. It's a beautiful street. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So, you know, shall I join my turn? This is my first time. Yeah. Tell me how you...
Yeah, I'll take over the mic. So make sure, you dig in, because I don't want your noodles to get cold there. But, encouraging all of our viewers to leave your comments, leave your questions, and we will try to answer as much as we can, as much of them, and read them out live as much as we can. But anyway, again, this is one of the tea houses in Lhasa, one of the oldest ones that was founded in 1978, according to the owner. And it's super popular here. We were here just a few hours ago, and this place was just booming and so full. They've opened like actually a couple of rooms. I can count one, two. There's at least another room back there, and then a second one further out. So this place is huge, and it's packed. And we're talking about, what is it, 4 p.m. right now? And so I've heard that also in the morning is just the place to be where you're going to have tea. That rhymed. The place to be where you're going to have tea. Anyway. Awesome. I'm going to hand the microphone back to
Thank
you.
Thank you very much to give me the precious time to enjoy the noodle.
So how was it?
It's great. I mean, it's great. It's, you know, it's not too chewy. I mean, there are people telling me it's very chewy. 就是有人跟我说它会很硬，但其实没有很硬。
这个怎么说？看自己吧。有些觉得很硬，有些觉得没有那么硬。
I mean, the flavor of the broth is absolutely amazing. It's beef broth, right?
Mm-hmm.
但这个汤特别好喝，对吧？汤，肉汤嘛。
一会儿再给你点一碗吧。All right, okay, because Puchi is helping us greatly today, we are going to present her a special gift of CGTN.
Which I have in my bag over there.
Over there, okay.
This
is your bag, okay.
Thank you so much.
So this is like a surprise gift for Puchi. It's a CGTN special gift. So Oscar, going to show it to the viewers first.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Let's unveil this. Should we have her open it or should I open it? What do you think?
Let's open it together,
shall we? Let's open it together.
不是，今天就是我们 我们送了你一个礼物，今天就是一个就是我们这个 CGTN 特别特制的一个礼物，你要不要打开看一看？
哦，可以啊。
啊，好好好。She has some for us as well.
Okay. Well, I'm glad we had something for her because imagine if we didn't have anything to give her.
Gonna be embarrassing.
Very embarrassing.
Super embarrassing. Okay. 你要不要打开看一下？
哦，可以啊。
Okay.
这个好好看，我很喜欢。
You like it? 你喜欢吗？
我喜欢。
你可以打开看一下，嗯，你可以展开看一下，没关系，你可以打开，没事。来，我来帮你，没关系 ，OK。
She knows how to unwrap gifts. I guess she gets many of them.
All right. Okay.This is a scarf, you know, CGTN special scarf.
好好看，我好喜欢，好好看，谢谢，好好看。
Okay.
So should we see what she had for us?
All right, okay. 所以今天你给我们，你给我们带了什么东西呢？我们可以看一下吗？
今天我给你们准备了转经筒，然后你们看吧，你们喜欢哪个颜色就选一个。
That thing we miss at the gift shop, man.
And that's the first thing I was trying to ask what, you know, because I see a lot of people outside in the street holding these, and I hate to get it dirty. I don't want to get it dirty, but
okay.
So then I spin it.
Okay.
So
clock.
I don't want to insult anybody anymore.
No. So the clockwise is the right way to do it.
Perfect.
And I think, Puchi, 你可以给他讲一下转经筒在咱们藏族人民的生活里大概是一个。你们一般什么时候会用到它吗？它是一个怎么样的东西？
转经筒的话，我们这种年轻人的话基本上不会用，然后到了三十岁以上吧，都会用转经筒。
She said this is for people age 30 years and above.
Perfect.
That's
perfect.
us.
She knew how to calculate her age.
Yeah. 我们都三十岁了，所以说。
然后这个是就是转经。跟信仰有关系，这不是玩的。你们拿到家里可以放一些高处，不要乱放，就是。
She said this is something to do with their faith, so it's not a toy, you know.
Right.
It shouldn't be like a toy. This is something, you know. Can you stop spinning for just one second?
Sorry,
you know. All right. Okay. So this is, you know, some Buddhism mantra on it. You know. Sorry, I forgot. You know, it should be that way. It's some Buddhism mantra on it.So, can you,
就是咱们这上的六字真言。
六字真言 ，Om Mani Padme Hum， Om Mani Padme Hum。
这个是我们每天祈祷的时候会念的。
对，都会念六字真言嘛，这是六字真言，五行的，然后，宗教的一个法器，就是法器一个法器。
So this is like an artifact. So for religious purpose, with the mantra, Buddhism mantra on it, that you're supposed to, you know, read it when you're praying. So like when you do the spinning, it's like you're praying.You know, so when you hold it as well. So she also added that we shall put it, you know, when you take it home, you shall put it on the top of your, you know, put it somewhere high. Don't put it on the floor because, you know, that's something you pay your respect
right.
to the local tradition, yeah, and culture.
So can she explain very quickly why people over 30 are supposed to get these gifts?
Okay. I want to ask this too.
Yeah.
为什么年轻人不玩这？为什么我们都是三十岁以上的？为什么？
不是哦，我们年轻人的话就是有点忙嘛，就有信仰，但就是没时间，
I mean, she's very honest. She said young people are pretty busy, you know, with this kind of stuff. But when you, you know, get older, you have more leisure time, you can do this more. But you know, it's a very common thing here. You know, you see, you know, on the Bakur Street, you see old people's, different people's.Spinning it all the time, you know, very dedicated pilgrims. Yeah.
Yeah, I had never seen anything like it until I arrived to Tibet, and I know it's part of the regional culture and the religion, and so. But I was always curious. I really didn't know what this was all about.
Yeah.
So I'm very grateful that she was able to explain that, and it's such a wonderful gift. And now that I know, you know, the respect that it deserves, you know, it's that much special to receive. So I'm very very grateful. 谢谢你 Yeah.Thank you so much. This is a great gift.
Okay. Yeah. So, because since we've had a long day, we had some great sweet tea, and we have some delicious Tibetan noodles. We're sitting in one of the most busiest sweet tea house here in Lhasa, and with me is Oscar and Puchi. So, and let me thank Puchi again.
非常谢谢你今天抽空来参加我们 CGTN 的节目。
客气了，我很高兴认识你们两个。
She's happy to know us. Yeah. So, what about you know, what about, you know, we end this thing, you know, with a very common Tibetan farewell? You know, do you think it's
I think it's very appropriate, but right. I'm going to have to follow one of you two because, okay. again, I'm still learning. Only day three here.
All right, okay. 所以说我们在藏语里跟大家说再见的话，然后我们大家跟大家再见的话，一般用藏语怎么说？我们跟我们的这个网友，我们跟我们现在正在观看的观众朋友们再见，用藏语怎么说呢？我们一起说吧，你教教我们。
就是，修果。
修果。
连接修果，连接。
Shugo. Shugo. You do it.
Can you repeat again?
Henge. Henge.
Henge.
Henge. Shugo.
Henge Shugo.
Henge Shugo.
Okay.
So, yeah. So we, you know, we finish our noodle and then, you know, we say goodbye to our followers. So until next time, see you. Keep watching CGTN's live stream. We are Big Bear Brothers. Vote for us. And also Puchu. Thank you. And Shinge Shugo.
Shinge Shugo. Shinge Shugo.
Just delay. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.